mad.
Fishing with dead baits part two. That's when I last caught a pike on camera.
There he is.
How's it going there, guys? Today I'm with Aaron and we're down our river. He's got two pike rods out. I put one pike rod out and a carp rod. So really I came out today just to test out my new fox bite lines I got for Christmas. And quite good. And as I'm talking now, Aaron's bite line's going off. That's twice now Aaron's started to have some bit of activity. So on my carp video, once before, and I was going for pike when I was just leaving at the airman. I use these fruit tether, they're called, and these are pop up. Nice bright pink colour, and I thought I'd give it a try down the river, because you don't really get bright pink colours, really, do you? For my pike, which ended on the bottom, it just has a trace on it, I literally just put it out there. I'm using it for smelt. Because these have done me a pretty good job in the past, and I made a video about these, how good they are. I've never actually caught a carp down a river before, so this will be a first, but I'm not expecting to catch one. I just never really went for them, so I thought if I start going for them, I'll have a chance of catching a carp, won't I? And of course, got to put a pike one out, chance of getting pike, but I haven't got any on top. So I don't know how this is going to go down, because I don't really fish the bottom down the river. So who knows, maybe I catch, maybe I won't. Really want to, not just for me, for you guys to actually see something in this video. But trust me, I'll be sure to try. So me and Aaron are just sitting down, just about to have our hot chocolate, and my pike alarm just went off mad. Yeah, it came off, sadly, but it took it so quick. And it was fighting like mad. And I was saying to Aaron, it seems too quick to be a pike. So it could have been a trout, maybe even a perch. Whatever the hell that was, it's still in there somewhere. Look, guys, my bite line didn't go off, I just lifted it up, and there's a pike on there. Going for my smell. Right, we're trying to get it in now.
There he is.
Guys, just like I said, we've got him in now. Quite a good fighter, and he was, what is it going now?
£3.11.
Yeah, £3.11. Yeah. Far off £4, but he's a nice one.
There he goes.
Last time I had a pike on camera that I caught, actually accidentally deleted the video. I was at Broom Lake, and I think it's called fishing with worms and boilies, but yeah, I'm going to have to try and do that video again. That was ages ago, probably coming into September time. So yeah, the last time I caught on camera and the video stood up was probably when I was fishing with sprats and I was down the river. Actually no, not even, just said, look, last time I caught fishing with dead baits part two. That's when I last caught a pike on camera, and that was in September, mid-September time. So that's quite a while ago. I mean, I've caught plenty of pike afterwards, just not all on camera. Like I said, the one on camera, I deleted the video by accident. So now I've got, instead of a carp rod on bottom, I've changed it now, so I've got a pike float on top. So me and Aaron, we've moved back to our old spot, which we always get to. Where there's waterfall, because we've had great success in the past and this year's been pretty good. And I know last time we didn't catch anything, but it's always worth a try, like, you know, actually fish. Well, we're leaving it at that now today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Cheers again, Aaron, for being here. Okay. Probably do more videos down the river, because we haven't really been down here for a while, have we? Yeah. I mean, call that, alright, pike earlier, where the two rivers meet. But a little bit of disappointment for no carp, which I expected, and no more pike coming out. But, you know, we gave it a go, as we always do. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.